If you got the design of the Samsung Galaxy S4 and shrunk it down to size, you'd get the Samsung Galaxy S4 Mini, but it isn't exactly the same as the Galaxy S4. Oh no, the specs are pretty different, but we're going to start off with that design. And shrunk down, it produces a 4.3-inch display. It's a QHD display, so not the highest resolution out there, which is a bit of a shame considering this is a £350-plus handset. Still, you do get the same overall design. It's available in black and white with all that hyperglaze fantasticness. You've got that fake metal rim around the sides, physical home button on the front, two capacitive buttons either side, front-facing 1.9-megapixel camera. Flipping it round, removable back cover, 8-megapixel rear-facing camera, 1900mAh battery, and microSD expandability. The screen itself, as we said, is just QHD, so it's not all that sharp, but it is AMOLED, so it does pop nicely and is pretty responsive to the touch. When it comes to the Android version on board, you've got Samsung's TouchWiz on top of Android 4.2. And while Android 4.2 is a very nice new version, you won't see all that much of it. TouchWiz is quite heavily laid on top, just like its bigger brother, the Galaxy S4. You don't have AirView or Air Gesture or some of the more advanced smart features, but we'd generally say performance is about the same, which is pleasant considering you've got a dual-core processor in here compared to the quad-core S4. The camera around the back is an 8-megapixel snapper, the same as a Galaxy S3. In low light, it actually performs quite well when compared side by side to the S4. In good lighting though, you're not going to get as much key detail as you would from the Galaxy S4's 13-megapixel sensor. Still, nighttime shots are supported with a decent flash and you get perfectly good 1080p video recording. The Galaxy S4 also has quite a few more shooting modes, making it ultimately a more premium camera phone. On the connectivity front, you've got Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, etc. on board, so all the standard connectivity features plus NFC as well. You've got LTE too for some super fast internet, so you'll be well catered for if you're on O2 or EE, two of the only networks at the moment that support it. Performance-wise, the 1.7 GHz dual-core processor and the 1.5 GB of RAM power things along nicely, like we said. There is an insane amount of stutter when it comes to the gallery, which we've noticed across all of the Samsung Galaxy S4 range, and it is a real shame. It does hamper the usability a great deal. Overall, though, when it comes to gaming, it's perfectly capable, and the UI is generally pretty smooth. The 8 GB of onboard storage is a little bit paltry, but you can upgrade it to 64 GB. And with the 1900mAh battery on board, you'll easily get a day out of this thing, if not more. So all in all, the Samsung Galaxy S4 Mini does have some nice features, many of which we haven't touched upon, like the infrared remote control. You can read more about it in the review. However, at the price it comes in at, it is just a little bit too expensive.